This is a job for Superman.
Superman. He always saves the day. But when do we, mere mortals, act heroically?
Are you all right?
I think that most people actually have a first impulse to help others.
Yale professor David Rand studies human cooperative behavior and analyzes why some people are willing to sacrifice themselves for the greater good. He has a theory.
If you recognize this as a situation where people need to be helped, you have an impulse to run towards. But if you stop and think about it, you might realize, oh wait, there's danger involved in running towards, I should probably run away.
To show how this theory works, we invited four ThinkProgress reporters to play a simple game designed by Professor Rand.
You're going to be asked to write a number either 0 or 10.
Each person has $10 to keep or put into a communal pot. The money in the pot doubles and is divided evenly between the participants. So you always make more by keeping your money, but you're screwing over your neighbor. Tara and Jack will immediately write down how much they'll contribute. Laurel and Ian will think about it first.
Ready, set, go.
Okay.
Go.
God, I don't know.
So everyone at the same time. One, two, three.
Sorry.
Damn you, Laurel.
I trusted you.
I've thought about writing 10, and I really weighed with it. If I had to do it immediately, I might have chosen differently. But I wasn't sure if everybody else was gonna put the money in. And if you think about it, $5 more is, yes, not that lot more net, but percentage-wise.
Classic over-deliberation. But what happens when the stakes are higher? Say, life or death?
An amazing story. Two U.S. Marines credited with preventing a massacre today on board a packed train. The heavily armed gunman tackled as he was loading his AK-47.
So did they act impulsively?
I didn't really have much of a state of awareness. It wasn't really a conscious decision. We just kind of acted. There wasn't much thinking going on, at least on my end. I don't know about them. Spencer?
No, not at all.
Dr. Rand found that the less time people have to deliberate, the more likely they are to cooperate with the group. But that doesn't mean that using your intuition will make you more altruistic.
My theory is that your sort of intuitive default response depends on your life experiences. So if you're a kind of person who, in your daily life, it's typically advantageous to help others, then you internalize helping as your default because that's what typically works well. But if you come from a place where, you know, in general people don't trust each other, it's not safe, or you work in an organization that rewards being cutthroat, then you may wind up internalizing not helping as your default because that's the thing that typically works well.
So whether you're on a train, playing games with your coworkers, or trying to save the world, the less you think, the better off everyone else will be.